Hello friends, this video on Equilibrium Part 7 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. Before watching the video, please make sure that you have watched Part 1 to Part 6. Before that, let's check one question and say, why pure solids, pure liquids can be ignored while writing the equilibrium constant for the expression? See, equilibrium constant, when we write these values, for example, I have this reaction Cc plus T. So my Kc will be what? C to the power C, capital D to the power small d, by A to the power small a, and B to the power small. Now all these are in moles per liter. So we talk about pure solid. The moles per liter will be constant. If you talk about pure liquid, the moles per liter again will be constant. But if you talk about, let's suppose, aqueous solution. So, for example, I have sodium ion. So if I put, let's suppose, 100 sodium ions in 1 liter, another case I put 100 sodium ions in 100 liter. So if you see in both the case, the value is changing. It is 100 moles per liter. And here it will be 1 mole per liter. So if you see in both the cases, the sodium ion concentration was same, but the volume changed and this value also changed, moles per liter. And here we are writing only moles per liter. So the moles per liter value change when you talk about the gas or the aqueous thing. Same thing in the gas also. If I have iodine gas, I have, let's suppose, 10 moles of iodine gas. In one case I have 1 liter of the gas, other case I have 10 moles of iodine gas in 10 liter. Or the flask, if you see in both the case, the moles per liter will change. In this case it will be 10 moles per liter, and in this case it will be 10 by 10, that is 1 mole per liter. So in that case, for the gas and the aqueous things, the moles per liter value change, but for the pure solids and pure liquids, the mole per liter value is constant. It is constant, it has some value, but just to make things simple, we ignore those constants. Let's take some example. We'll find the value of K in all this. So as I told, we'll ignore the solid part and pure liquid part. There is no pure solid, pure liquid parts, no nothing. So K will be what? NO. NO, the power what? 4 plus H2O in the gas form, the power 6 divided by O2 in the gas form, the power 5. NH3 ammonia in the gas form, the power. This will be my K. For this one also, if you see, there is all gas, so I can't ignore anything. So K will be what? NH3 to the power 2 divided by N2 gas to the power 1, and H2 is a gas to the power. So now you will take this H2 plus Cl2 gives 2 HCl gas. Here also, if you see, I can't ignore anything. So my K will be HCl to the power 2, Cl2 to the power 1, because there is only 1 here, and H2 also to the power 1. And that is last. Easy one. Just to prove whatever we are writing, that Kc is correct or not, so what these guys have done, they have done this experiment where H2 plus I2, they form to form 2HI. All gas. Now, they have done various experiments. The first experiment, what did was initial concentration of H2, they took this much, I2 took this much, and HI was 0. The second, they took initial concentration of H2 and I2 was this. There was no HI. Third, they took this concentration, there was no HI. Fourth, this concentration, no HI. Fifth, they took zero concentration for HI, there was no H2 and I2, just to prove that the backward reaction also possible. This thing happened on the backward side. And they took HI to be this much. And in this case, they took HI. Now, after some time, they observed that for case 1, the equilibrium value was this. The value of H2 was this, I2 was this, and HI was this. That's really for various other reaction, for reaction 2, the values were this. For reaction, let's suppose 5, the values were this. Now, what they have seen is, for this, the Kc turns out to be what? Hi square by H2. So for all these, if you find this value Hi square, if you square these and divide by this and this, you get a constant value. You can do this, square this and divide this by this and this, you get some value. You square this, divide this by this, you get same value. Any of this. And that's what proves that it has a constant value in equilibrium. Just an experimental way to prove whatever we have studied. The question says that for the following equilibrium, N2 plus O3 gives N2 plus O2, my Kc is this at 1000 Kelvin. Both the forward and reverse reaction are bimolecular reactions. What is the Kc for the reverse reaction? It's a very simple formula. See, I have NO plus O3 gives NO2 plus. So I have Kc has some value x. So the reverse reaction NO plus O3, my Kc will be what? 1 by x. Correct? So my K dash C, which I am talking about, nothing but 1 by this value, 6.3 into 10 to the power. 14. You solve this, you get 1.59 into 10 to the power minus 50. That is the answer. And since there was no unit here, you don't have any unit here. Let's take one example. The question says, what is the Kc for the following equilibrium? The reaction is SO2 plus O2 is an equilibrium. You can use this symbol or that symbol with SO3. All are in gas. And the concentration of SO2 is given 0.60 m, that is 0.60 moles per liter. Point O2 is 0.82 m, that is 0.82 moles per liter. And for SO3, concentration is 1.9 m, that is 1.9 m moles per liter. So for this equation, the Kc has to be what? Concentration of SO3, to the power 2 divided by concentration of O2. To the power 1, concentration of SO2 to the power 2, correct, because this is 2. Let's put the values here. SO3 is what? 1.90 m square. O2 is what? 0.82 m, right? And SO2 is what? 0.60 m square. So if you solve this, you'll get 12.23. And what are the units? So this has 2. If you compare the unit, it will be m square. And here it will be m into m square. Correct? M square you'll get from 1.90 here. 1 m you'll get from 0.82 m. And here m square you'll get from 0.6 square. So this m square cancel, that is 1 by m, right? So that will be mu m inverse. That will be the unit. So this will be the Kc for this equilibrium. So we have to just write the Kc for all these equations. So let's take this first equation. Everything is in gas, so Kc for 1 will be what? NO to the power 2, because we have two NO molecules. Chlorine, only one, so Cl2 gas to the power 1. NOCl gas to the power 2, correct? Why 2? Because there are two NOCl molecules. This will be the Kc. Simple. Next, take this example. For second, my right hand side has CuO, it's solid, so ignore this part. NO2 gas will take this, oxygen gas will take, and CuNO32 solid will ignore this also, because we knew that for pure solids and pure liquids, the mole per liter, the molarity is constant, so we ignore that part. So let's write here NO2 to the power 4, O2 to the power 1, divide by nothing because this part is anyway ignored. Correct. Let's take the third part. So in third, let's take which all we have to ignore. So in third, we can't ignore anything. This is aqueous, this is liquid. This liquid we can ignore actually. The pure liquid, the molar concentration is constant. These two we can't ignore. So let's take this now. CH3COH we have. So concentration of CH3COH to the power 1 because there is 1 here. C2H5OH to the power again 1 because there is only 1. The stoichiometric coefficient is only 1, divided by the reactant side, that is CH3COOH5, and that will also be power 1 because the stoichiometric coefficient is 1. Let's take the fourth part. In fourth, we have this FeOH3 solid, we can ignore this part, other part we can't ignore. So for fourth, we want to find Kc to be 1 because there is nothing here. On the product side, on the reactant, we have Fe plus 3 to the power 1 and OH minus to the power 3. Similarly, let's take for this guy. Here I have I2 solid. We ignore this part. Other things are not solid. So we'll take those things. In fact, this is liquid actually, and this is gas, so I'll just write it here. Since this is liquid, I can ignore this part also. So what I am left with is, on the product side I have nothing, so I'll put 1 here. On the reactant side I have 5 fluorine molecules, so I'll write F2 to the power 5, and that is my answer. The question says the value of Kc is equal to 4.24 at 800 Kelvin. I told that the value of Kc is dependent on temperature, and also you should know the balanced reaction, right? Even if you, I mean actual reaction, because if you multiply everything by 2 or 3, the Kc value will change, right? So you should know the temperature and you should know the exact balanced reaction for defining a particular Kc. So I have this reaction here and I have this temperature at which the Kc is 4.24. We have to find the equilibrium concentration of carbon dioxide, hydrogen, carbon monoxide and water at 800 Kelvin. If only CO and H2O are present initially at 0.1 mole each concentration. We will take these kind of questions more later, but again, anyway, we have taken these questions, let me solve this. So here, if you see, it says that initially only CO and H2O were present and both were 0.1 mole each. And we have to find the equilibrium concentration of all these. So as I told, I have this equation CO plus H2O is an equilibrium with CO2 plus H2O. Everything is gas. So let's assume that at T is equal to 0, when you start, at that time my carbon monoxide was 0.1 mole, water was 0.1 mole, and carbon dioxide and hydrogen was 0. Let's assume T is equal to equilibrium, x mole of carbon monoxide and water is exhausted to create carbon dioxide and hydrogen. So this will be 0.1 minus x, so this will also become 0.1 minus x mole, this will become x mole, and this will also become x mole. Correct? Simple rule of stoichiometry. Now, if you want to find the Kc, Kc for this will be what? Concentration of CO2 into concentration of H2 by concentration of CO, concentration of H2. All raised to the power 1 only because the stoichiometric coefficient is 1 and all our gas will include all. So if you see at T is equal to equilibrium, CO2 is what? X. H2 is what? X. CO is what? 0.1 minus X. And H2O is what? 0.1 minus X. Correct. And this is equal to nothing but X square by 0.1 minus X square. And this value is nothing but 4.24 given. Now with this I get a quadratic equation. Correct. So if you solve this, you'll get the value of X to be 0.067 or 0.194. Can we take both these values? No. 0.194 mole we can't take, because I'm saying if you take 0.194 mole, the value of concentration of carbon monoxide will become negative, and that is not possible. Correct. I mean, the concentration can never be negative. It will have some positive value or zero value. Can never be negative. So we'll ignore this, and the value of X will take as 0.067 mole. If you take the value of X as 0.067 mole, which you'll get after solving this equation, the CO2 concentration will be what? X, that is 0.067. H2 concentration will be what? X, that is nothing but 0.067. What about CO? CO concentration is what? 0.1 minus X, that is 0.1 minus 0.067, that is 0.033 mole. Similarly for water also. Similarly for H2O also, we will get 0.033 mole. Correct. Thank you. Visit examfear.com to watch free educational videos, try free online tests, get the best quality study materials, study from the best tutors and mentors, and much more. Thanks once again.